We will start now to explain the electronics course in English for English students. We will start now by explaining lecture one. This will be the access code of the electronic course on the Blackboard. This is the enroll access code, and this is the electronics course name. Why we study electronics course? We study electronics course since we surrounded by different electronic devices, such as cell phones, cars, computers, TVs, and medical devices. And these devices are electronics, which means that they are hardware components that are built of many smaller devices that we need to know its main building blocks. These devices are created from small devices such as diodes and transistors. So we need to study the main idea of diodes and transistors that are used to create these electronic devices. The electronic course, after finishing electronic course, you will make use of these courses in studying logic design courses and many other courses such as data communication, computer architecture, embedded system, and many other courses. We will explain in the electronic course. First is some basic circuit elements such as resistance, voltage and current sources, and the capacitor and inductor. I mean that while drawing any electronic circuit, it is created. Or contain some basic building block or some basic elements such as a resistor and voltage and current sources. We will study these elements. Then after creating our electronic circuit, we will study some circuit analysis techniques that help us to get unknown value in the circuit. Some of these circuit analysis techniques, example of these methods are electronic laws such as Ohm law, KVL, KCL, current division rule, and voltage division rules. Then we will study mesh and nodal analysis methods, and then we will study the Sevenen and the Norton methods. And in addition, we will study source transformation. These are some rules, some straightforward methods that we will use to get any unknown value or to make analysis of the electronic circuit that we have. Then we will study the semiconductors and its main idea. Then we will study some main devices that are based that are created from semiconductor materials such as a diode and transistor. We will study the difference between intrinsic and extrinsic material and how can we convert the intrinsic to extrinsic material. Concerning the grading scheme or grading criteria of the electronic course, we will have final exam, which is out of 60 grades. The midterm exam will be out of 20. We will have two quizzes, which are out of 12 grades. We will have quiz one and quiz two. Quiz one will be before midterm, and quiz two will be after the midterm. Then we have remaining 8 grades, which will be on group assignments that will be held on the section. This grading criteria is changed from one term to another, but this is the grading criteria that we will use in this term. Okay, after studying electronic course and these topics that we talk about, as a student will get the knowledge of the practice to do analyze for simple electrical circuit and analyze complicated circuit and compare between various analysis methods such as nodal and mesh analysis methods. Then we'll, the student will have the knowledge to describe the operation of basic semiconductor devices and know the main characteristic of these devices and know as some examples of these devices such as diode and transistors. While studying the electronics course, you will have some basic material such as lecture slides and lecture recording. Then you will have also the sheets and their answers. In addition, you will make use of some textbooks, some public. Public textbooks such as electronic device and circuit theory. You can have the PDF of these devices, these textbooks, by just copying and pasting this name in the Google, and you will find the PDF of this textbook. These textbooks contain the explanation of the concepts that we explain in the lecture. In addition, it have many examples, solved examples, and the practice examples on the circuits and the theory that we study. In addition of these two textbooks, you will have, I prefer a YouTube channel called NISO Academy Analog Electronics that has explanation of the main building, the main concepts of electronics course in a short duration of time. Okay. We will start studying the basic circuit elements, as we said. Some of the main main building block or main elements of the circuit is the electrical current. Current can be defined as the rate of flow of electrical charge, where electrical charge is referred as the moving of electrons. Okay, current is the rate of flow of electrical charge. The unit of electrical charge is called ampere. So we can refer the current as Q over T, a number of charges over a second per time. Then we will study the electrical voltage, which is called the potential difference between two points. The volt is also called the potential difference, or it can be referred as the work needed per unit charge to move a tested charge between two points. The work is that we need to move some charge between two points. So we can define the voltage as work over a Q, or work over a number of charges that needed to be moved. The unit that is used to calculate the electric volt is electrical potential difference is called a volt. Then we will study the power or the energy. The power is the rate per time at which electric energy is transferred by an electrical circuit. Is the rate that the energy is transferred. Okay. We can refer that the power is power rule is 1i multiplied by LV. We can derive this this equation from the current and the voltage rule. But generally, the power is called is equals to the current multiplied by the volt. The unit of the power is watt or 1 joule per second. Then we have to know the, some of basic sources, independent sources and dependent sources. What I mean by independent sources? Independent sources, from its name, it means that it doesn't depend on any other source. Generally, I have a current source or a voltage source. Current source, when the current source is called independent, it means that the value over the independent source will be explicit value, such as 1, 2, 3, or 10, or 20, or any other value. When I explain the dependent source, it means that the value over the dependent the current source will not be explicit value, will not be explicit 10. It will be 10 multiplied by other variable. Okay, this is the main difference between dependent and independent source. For independent sources, I have current source and voltage source. The current source notation will be circle such have an arrow in it. But the voltage source will be a circle that have positive and negative sign in it. Okay. So I have this is a current source and this is a voltage source. Both of them are circle. When the symbol of the source is circle, it means that it is independent. Okay, when the symbol of the source will be a diamond, it will be a dependent source. Okay, so I have two main types of sources, independent sources and dependent sources. Independent sources will have explicit value or specific value of the current or the voltage source. But the independent source, its value will be multiplied by other variable. This variable may be V, maybe I, maybe any other value. Okay? Maybe any other variable. This is the symbol of the independent source. It will be circle. The symbol of the dependent source will be diamond. Okay, okay. For the current source, the dependent source and the current, it will be diamond with arrow. Okay. For the dependent source, voltage source, it will be diamond with positive and the negative. What is the difference between these diamond with arrow and diamond with positive and negative? These are the two symbols. What are the value of the difference between these two symbols? The difference is in the value over the symbol. If the value depends on current, A or R is 10. 10 multiplied by I, 10 multiplied by I, this is the difference. But here we have a value multiplied by V, a value multiplied by V. Okay? Again, I need by dependent source. Dependent source means that the source I have has a value multiplied by variable. If the variable is I say that these sources are called controlled current. Controlled current, which means that it depends on current. Voltage controlled, it means that it depends on volt. Okay. So I have the independent sources, which are circles, circle with arrow current source, circle with positive and negative voltage source. I have dependent sources, the diamond with arrow, diamond with positive and negative, diamond with arrow current source, a diamond with positive and negative voltage source. This is a dependent source since it is a diamond. It is a current source dependent such since it is a diamond. What is the difference between this symbol and this symbol? The variable that is multiplied by, it is multiplied by I, it is multiplied by V. When it is multiplied by I, it's called current controlled. When it is multiplied by V, it is called voltage controlled. So this source is a dependent source, voltage controlled, current source. This source is a dependent source, voltage controlled, voltage source. Okay, and so on. For this lecture, we talk the course outline and speak about what is the electrical current, electrical voltage, and electrical power. We will go to the other lecture. The lecture two. Okay, this is lecture two. We talk about the electrical current, which is a rate of charges per time. We talk about the voltage or the potential difference, which is the work needed to transfer some of charges between two points. Then we talk about the bar, which is the voltage multiplied by V. Sorry, voltage multiplied by I. Then we talk about independent sources and dependent sources. This figure is an example of a circuit that has many sources. This circuit contains a dependent source, independent source, independent source, and dependent source. How can I know that it is a dependent or independent? When it is a circle, it is independent. This is a independent and independent since they are circle. This is a dependent source since it is a diamond. Okay. So it is a independent source. Independent source, dependent source. What is the type of the independent source, current or voltage? This is a independent source, current source. Okay, this is a independent voltage source. Independent current source, independent voltage source. This is a dependent current source. Dependent current source. Dependent on what? Dependent on current, so it is a current controlled, dependent current controlled current source. Okay. What about this circuit? This circuit contains two main types of sources: circle, independent source; diamond, dependent source. So it is a independent source, dependent source. What is the type of the independent source? Voltage source. So it is a independent voltage source. It is a dependent current source. Independent voltage source, dependent current source. Okay. With this current source is dependent on I since it is multiplied by I variable, so it is a current controlled in a dependent current controlled current source. Okay. Then we will talk about resistance, or we have to define, we have to differentiate between two, three main elements: resistor, resistance, and resistivity. Resistor is a device that I can use, is a hardware that I can use in, I can hold in my hand. But the resistance is a quantity over this device. The resistance is an electric quantity that measure how the device or a material reduces the electrical current flowing. So the resistor is a device, the resistance is a quantity. What is the the meaning of this quantity? The resistance is a quantity that measures how the device or material reduces the electrical current. When I put a resistance on resistor or on the circuit, I use it to reduce the current that flow on this circuit. Reduce the current. When the current in the circuit is say 10, I would like to reduce it to be 8. So I have to set a resistance in this circuit with a quantity that reduces it by only 2 ampere. Okay. So the resistance is a quantity that measures how the device or a material reduces the electrical current that flows through it. The unit of the resistance is called ohm. Okay. Generally, to both the quantity over a resistor, we have two methods. We can put a quantity or a number, or we can create the resistor to be in colors, such that the combination of some of colors create some value. Say gray, yellow, and white, and orange create say 390 kΩ. Okay. And so on. Yani, the color code that put on the resistor is a method that we use to put a quantity over the resistor. How this color code is created, or what are the main combinations that we have to learn, it is out of the scope of this course. Since we will talk about the Ohm's law, which relate three variables, voltage, well, current, we resistor, or resistance of a device or of a circuit. Ohm's law states that LV equal I multiplied by LR, which means that LI equals V over R, and so on for LR. We'll talk about some notation or some definition called the resistivity. Resistance is a quantity. Resistivity is a quantity, but differ from a material to another. Okay. So if the resistor, if the device, the resistor device is created from a silver material, it has a resistivity 1.6. Then I will make a resistor of a silver to have a resistance with other quantity, this quantity will depend on or will be affected of the material type. Okay, the resistivity is a quantity over the material that that depend on the material type. Okay, resistivity is a quantity. Resistance is a quantity. Resistivity is a quantity, but resistivity depends on the material. Okay. In addition, resistance depends on resistivity, which means that LR equal resistivity for L over LA, which means such that L is the length of the wire, while A is the area of the section of the wire, where rho is the resistivity. Okay. You have to know this rule of resistance and this rule of resistance, which is given by Ohm's law. R equal V over R. and ال r equal rho l over a. So I have two methods to calculate the resistance. Then I will have other rotation or other term called conductance and conductivity. Conductance is the inverse of resistivity, which means Lj equal 1 over R. Conductance, how the material or how the wire connect or allow the device to connect a current. Okay, J is a quantity, R is a quantity. This is a quantity that allows the device to pass a current, but R is a quantity that makes the current, makes the device reduce the current. Okay, so J equal 1 over R. J is a quantity, while R is a quantity. Conductivity is a quantity, but depends on the material. Okay, if I have conductance and resistance, J equal 1 over R. Conductivity or resistivity? Resistivity is rho, or conductivity is called sigma. Conductivity and resistivity, both of them are quantity, but depends on the material. Okay, so I will have J equal sigma multiplied by A over L. This slide explains that the power have a rule V multiplied by I, okay? But given Ohm's law, which said that V equal 1 multiplied by R, so I can replace the V in this rule by I multiplied by R, okay? Power equal V of V multiplied by R. Using Ohm's law, I will replace V to be I multiplied by R, then I will multiply by I. So I will have the power equal I square R. Okay? Using Ohm's law, I can replace I in this rule, the power equal V multiplied by I. I can replace V using Ohm's law, or I can replace I using Ohm's law. If I replace V using Ohm's law, I will have I square multiplied by R. If I replace I using Ohm's law, I will have power equal V square over R. V square over R, since I equal V over R. V over R, this is I, then I multiply it by V, it will get V square over R. Okay, this slide explains that the power can be got by using three rules, V multiplied by I, I square R, V square over R. Okay. This slide explains that if I have a voltage source that dissipates some power, this power will be absorbed or taken by this source. This source will use it. Okay. So I have two main types of power: power delivered or power absorbed. Power delivered or dissipated, or delivered or dissipated, or supplied is the source power. Okay, the absorbed power is the used power through the circuit. Okay, this power will have different sign than this absorbed power. Okay, these two powers values will have two different signs. But as we can imagine that these two powers will have the same value. Okay, since this is the source and this is the element in the circuit, these elements will take all the power in as supply. Okay, so if I have resistance 1, resistance 2, resistance 1 with power 1, resistance 2 with power 2, B1 plus B2 will be equal to the power source. Okay, the power delivered will be equal to the power absorbed. Both of them will have different sign. Okay, how to get a power of a component in the circuit. As we can conclude, the power has a value and a sign. Okay, how to get the power value? We will get the power value using the power rule. How to get the power sign? Okay, let's start to find the power in this circuit given I equal 4. It asks about to get the power given I equal 4 and I equal negative 3. So let's start to find the I first, I equal 4. B1 equal I multiplies by LV. Okay? I multiplies by LV. What is the value of the I? I is the current that passes through the circuit. Well, I given is 4, so I equal 4. What is the value of V? V will be 8. So the power will be 4 multiplied by 8, which will be 32. This is the value of B1. What will be the sign of the power? It will be negative 32. Why it will be 32? Negative 32. To get the sign of the power, you will have to look at the current in the circuit. The current in the circuit is I1. You have to look at this current entering this element in which direction? The negative direction. So it will be negative 32. Okay? So the power value will be negative 32. Why it is negative 32? Since the current entering this element in the negative direction. Okay. What about the value of the power in this element? A power equal I multiplied by LV. Okay, this is a voltage source. So its V value is 2 multiplied by I. It is a dependent voltage source. Its value of the voltage equal 2 multiplied by I. What is the value of the current? It will be I. Again, V2 equals I multiplied by LV. The I value is I, LV value is 2 multiplied by I. So the power equal 2 multiplied by I square. Okay? Well, I value is 4. So it is multiplied by 4, multiplied by 4, multiplied by 4, which will be 32. What will be the sign of the power? We get the sign. We get the sign of the power element by looking at the current in the circuit and see in which direction it enters this element. The current enters this element in the positive direction, so the power will be positive. Okay? B1 will be 30, will be negative 32, B2 will be positive 32. Okay? For this circuit, he asked about to get the B1, B2, B3, B4. Okay. B equals I multiplied by LV. Any B equals I multiplied by V. For B1, what is the value of I and what is the value of B? As can be shown, the current value is 10 and the voltage value is 16. So it will be 160. The sign will be negative. Why the sign will be negative? When I look at the current that passes through the circuit, it will be in this direction, then it will go or enter this element in the negative direction. So the sign will be negative. B1 will be negative 160. For B2, B2 equals I multiplied by LV. What is the value of I? The value of I, as can be shown, is 10 ohm. The value of volt is 6. So B will be equal to 6 multiplied by 10, which is 60. The sign is negative. Why the sign is negative? When I see the current in the circuit, it enters this element in the negative direction. So it is a negative 60. Okay? For B3, what is the value of B3? B3 equal I multiplied by LV. As can be shown, LV value is 22. Well, current value is 6. So B3 value will be 6 multiplied by 22, which is 132. What about the sign? It will be positive. Why it is a positive? Since the current is in this element, the current enters this element in the positive direction. This is the positive direction. Positive part of the battery. So the B3 will be 132 positive. Okay. For B4, B4 equal I multiplied by LV. Okay, what is the value of I? It is a current source, so its current value is 0.4 multiplied by I. This is the current. What about the voltage? So voltage value. The current is what is it? Okay, so the power will be 0.4 multiplied by L I multiplied by 2. What is the value of I? It can be noted that I is 1 is 10. Okay, so the value of the power will be 88. This is for lecture 1.